How was the Burj Khalifa built? Crafted from the dreams of architects and the sweat of thousands, the Burj Khalifa redefines what it means to touch the sky. With each of its 828 meters, it tells a story of ambition, precision, and collaboration. Be it the towering height, the stunning design, or the revolutionary construction techniques, every aspect of this architectural wonder is steeped in history and innovation that most people still don't know. In this video, we will cover everything regarding how the Burj Khalifa was built, including the material and machinery used, the number of man hours put in, the challenges faced during its construction, and much more. So, let's dive in. Before you construct a building, the very first thing you need is to set a proper budget. And when you want to build the tallest building in the world, you need a huge budget and a lot of resources. Imagine having the blueprint for the world's tallest skyscraper in your hands, like the dream that towered before Muhammad Alibar, the chairman of Emaar. He laid out a budget of $1.5 billion US to bring the Burj Khalifa into reality. Back in 2005, a powerful financial alliance was born. Mashreq Bank, Emirates Bank International, and Abu Dhabi Commercial Bank came together, forming a powerhouse to fuel this skyscraper project. They signed a financing deal with none other than the Korean construction giant Samsung Corporation, along with its top-notch project partners Bilhassa 6 Construct and ArabTech. Here's the kicker. Almost 90% of the building space that could be sold was snapped up before it was even built. So who were the masterminds behind its design? The honor fell to the global architecture and engineering titan, the Chicago office of Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill LLP, with Adrian Smith FAIA, RIBA, acting as the consulting design partner. This selection was a declaration of innovation, pushing the boundaries of what's possible in architectural design. The chosen design underwent an exhaustive peer review program, evaluating every aspect of the structure's safety and efficacy. To support an 828-meter-tall skyscraper, the engineers had a straightforward plan. To reach skyward, one must first anchor deeply. This led to the creation of an exceptionally solid foundation system. There lies a massive reinforced concrete mat, itself resting on 192 board-reinforced concrete piles. These piles plunge 50 meters below the surface, ensuring the tower's stability. The mat, a staggering 3.7 meters in thickness, was not built in one go. Instead, it required four separate concrete pours, which together accounted for 12,500 cubic meters of concrete. This process was undertaken by Bauer Specialty Bau and Middle East Foundations, renowned for their expertise in deep foundation engineering. Their choice of equipment was equally impressive, using the Bauer BG40 drill rig, noted for its exceptional torque capability of 40 nanometers. While this might seem excessive for drilling holes, the additional power reduces stress on the machinery, allowing for seamless operation under demanding conditions. In total, 45,000 cubic meters of concrete, weighing over 110,000 tons, were poured into the foundations, equating the volume to 18 Olympic-sized swimming pools. The builders opted for high-density, low-permeability concrete in the foundations, supplemented by a cathodic protection system underneath the mat. This strategic choice was aimed at combating the corrosive effects of groundwater. The groundwork for the Burj Khalifa began in 2004, with each deep pile designed for cast-in-situ construction. The site's soil conditions were advantageous. The soft yet stable ground facilitated easier excavation. This was a fortunate circumstance compared to other regional sites, where the presence of natural limestone necessitates preliminary breaking. Starting in May 2007 and reaching completion by September 2009, the process of applying the tower's skin was a monumental task. Initially, the installation pace was around 20 to 30 panels daily, but through skill and efficiency, this number soared to an impressive 175 panels per day. The Burj Khalifa didn't just aim for the skies in height, but also set the record for the highest aluminum and glass facade installation at 512 meters. This feat is as if the tower draped itself in the metallic equivalent of 5 A380 aircraft, or strung the Eiffel Tower around its exterior 293 times in stainless steel. Reflective glazing, coupled with aluminum and textured spandrel panels, adorned with vertical stainless steel fins, make up the tower's shimmering exterior. This cladding was close to 26,000 hand-cut glass panels, placed by over 300 specialists from China. Designed to endure the scorching Dubai sun, the tower's exterior underwent intense testing, even using a World War II airplane engine to simulate wind and water stress. This was all in the name of ensuring its durability and safety against any environmental hazards. Also, it was a big challenge faced by the designers to create a sustainable design that could withstand the harsh climate of Dubai. Talking about manpower, the construction of the Burj Khalifa was nothing short of a global symphony, bringing together over 60 contracting and consulting firms from around the world. At the height of its construction frenzy, the site buzzed with the energy of over 12,000 workers and contractors each day, creating a melting pot of over 100 nationalities. This monumental effort underscores not just the physical height the project achieved, but also the vast human collaboration it has. In fact, Imar, the force behind this iconic tower, estimates that the construction of the Burj Khalifa clocked in an astonishing 22 million man-hours. After all, building the tallest structure in the world is no small feat. Among the challenges that the construction team faced, handling the enormous quantity of aluminum was a big one. As we said earlier, the total weight of all the aluminum used on the Burj Khalifa exceeds that of 5 A380 aircraft. To manage this, a series of cranes were used to lift the aluminum panels to their required heights. In the start, there were three Favel Favco cranes that extended their reach up to level 156. Imagine the heart-stopping heights and the relentless pace. These machines were on the clock, round the clock, with their gears grinding and cables taut, all through the project's most intense periods. You'd guess it took a big army to keep these mechanical giants running smoothly, but you'd be wrong. A dedicated crew of just 9 drivers, rotating in shifts, took charge, ensuring that not a single moment was lost. But that wasn't all. There was also a dedicated team of 35 technicians always on standby. Their skills made sure everything worked smoothly. This group was just a small part of the massive effort, joining the 12,000 people who worked together to build the Burj Khalifa. The cranes lifted huge loads every day. They moved steel beams to build the skyscraper's frame, welding gear, high-up scaffolding, generators that buzzed with energy, and big tanks of diesel fuel for the engines. Every time they lifted something, it was like a carefully planned dance, fighting against gravity. This was all part of making a legendary building, made possible not just by steel and glass, but by people's hard work and smart thinking. When the Burj Khalifa opened its doors in January 2010, it broke numerous records. For example, it zoomed right past the Taipei 101 in Taiwan, which was the tallest until then at 508 meters. The Burj Khalifa set a new record, reaching higher than any building or structure anyone had seen before. But it wasn't just about being the tallest. It also grabbed titles for having the highest floor where people could actually work or live, and for its outdoor observation deck, which is way up there in the sky. You can stand on this deck and feel like you're on top of the world. It beat a lot of records, making it a superstar in the world of skyscrapers. So this was the incredible story of how the Burj Khalifa was built. The way engineers, contractors, and workers came together to create this massive structure is truly remarkable. Be it the strategic choice of materials, the careful planning and execution, or the determination to overcome challenges, every aspect of this project reflects the spirit of innovation and determination. Let us know in the comments what you find the most fascinating about the Burj Khalifa and how it has inspired you. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more exciting content.